she's a pretty strange woman, but that's just how some people can be.
Yep.
Hi, that was the news broadcast for today. Thank you very much.
I've always liked writing, and English was probably always one of my favorite subjects. I was always strong in that, and I liked telling stories.
I dreamt of being a TV news anchor for a long time, and what better way to find out if that's what you want to do than to go and do it.
He started playing at the news when he was in like fourth grade. He would go downstairs into our family room and set up his little news desk, and he would do the news alongside Tom Brokaw, and it was just, you know, we just thought it was the cutest thing.
You know, I remember when I was growing up, I would watch the news with my parents and say, you know, I want to be like that, you know, like, I can do that.
She was a very happy baby. She was a very sweet baby, very happy, very outgoing. As a parent, you hope that you can give your kids the tools and the know-how to go out on their own, to follow their dreams.
Business is set up in such a way, though, that it's almost like a farm team program. You know, this is Abilene, Texas. This is a minor league team.
My name is Juanita Adame, and I am a multimedia journalist for KRBC in Abilene, Texas. It's an NBC affiliate. Do you need a VOSA?
Probably, but right now I'll just focus on that.
Okay. All right, text me.
Okay.
Initially, I went to school to be a teacher. My mom wanted me to be a teacher because she said that's the best job you could ever do in the whole world. By the time I was about 26, I thought, teaching is not for me. So I left school for a few years. I had my daughter. I had her when I was 22.
All right.
I came back to school when I was about 27, and I told my mom, I think I know what I want to do. And she said, you're a little too old for that, don't you think? And so I re-enrolled in school. I changed my major. I changed it to mass communications. Got my bachelor's degree when I was 28.
Alrighty, Nora. I'll see you later.
And then I got a job at a small newspaper in my hometown in Sanger. I worked there for 2 years. Then we thought, well, let's give it a shot. Let's move to Los Angeles. We moved to Los Angeles, and I looked for any job I could: production assistant, producer, editor's assistant, everything. And I got nothing.
We had to put them in the closet because they're really, really loud.
But it has involved some sacrifices, though, hasn't it?
A lot of sacrifices. The biggest sacrifice being when we moved down to L.A. She quit her job. I quit my job. I cashed in part of my retirement so that we could afford to move to L.A., thinking that there was all this opportunity waiting to happen.
We were there for a year, right? A year. We lost like all our money. We had all our savings. We lost that. And I thought, you know, I'm going to have to go to a small market. That's the only way that I'm going to be able to move up in this business.
What's happening at the state park? If the lake is dry and the pool is dry.
Of course, being older, you know, here you have these young, really pretty girls that come in, and you're just like, oh my God, here's a 36-year-old, you know, in the same market competing with somebody that's 23.
I made it.
All right.
So how challenging is that for you, being a VJ?
It depends on the equipment you have. I mean, I can carry around the camera, tripod. it depends. If sometimes equipment doesn't cooperate, like if your camera turns off suddenly, you know, that's the challenging part. And then I think actually finding good angles and taking time to get B-roll for me is probably the hardest.
You're not gathering the news by phone. You're gathering the news with your body in concert with equipment, and it's exhausting. My name is Mary Angela Bach. I used to be a TV journalist, and now I am an assistant professor at the University of Texas. Yep, she's a good girl. It's my dissertation dog. I was inspired to study video journalists specifically because I thought that smaller cameras were going to make the stories being told better. That's not what I found.
So I'm going to have you hold the mic just like the last time. What's Lake Abilene like right now?
Lake Abilene
You have to take a vacation. You have to take a break because you do burn out creatively, and sometimes you get home and you're just so exhausted.
But it's extremely physically taxing. I mean, you're carrying, even if you're carrying one of the smaller cameras, you're still carrying a gear bag, you're still carrying a tripod. To do a good job, you should also have at least one light with you, right, on a stand. So that adds up. You've got, okay, a laptop, and you know, you need a laptop that's souped up so that it can do video editing. So that's another 12 pounds, 10, 12 pounds. I mean, I know they're lighter and lighter and lighter, but that, it adds up. It adds up, so you still got 30 pounds of gear that you're schlepping around.
You know what, I'm gonna pull in here because I don't want us to get lost again.
You're not supposed to make phone calls while you're driving, but you're still driving. You're trying to get the information. You're setting it up, you're getting the video. If you're doing even the tiniest bit of a good job, you're getting that camera on the floor, you're putting it up high, you're moving it around.
I'm sorry. Thanks. 66 years. What is the, what's the magic? What's the formula? What's the ingredients behind?
Love a lot. Love a lot.
I want the sound of something.
We thought it'd be something cute.
Oh, you guys. That's so sweet of you guys. What's the secret to their love? You know, they say, don't get a king-size bed, so therefore nobody can leave.
My name is Matthew Torres. I am the weekend anchor and weekday reporter for KTAP News in Abilene. I am 24 years old, and I'm from everywhere, but I last came from Dallas, and I went to the University of North Texas in Denton. I'm Filipino. I was born in the Philippines, but I'm also, my mom is also 75% Spanish from Spain.
Still to come on KTAP News at 6, grab your cowboy hats and get ready to giddy up the world famous.
We leave college to go to small market, to go to Podunk, USA. You're going to become a national correspondent for CNN. You're going to be an anchor for Good Morning America. You are going to be the next Anderson Cooper, you know? Of course you have those dreams.
You guys are great, thank you. That scared me. I thought I didn't record.
And they were always my rock. 66 years.
So how long have you guys been together?
66 years.
Go off for treadway.
No, but I'll find
you'll that. Notice it.
Okay.
And it's somewhere they're saying under the overpass. Sounds okay. Like it's bad.
Okay.
Do you have time?
Yeah, I'll do
have
it.
Have a nice side phone call tonight. I'll keep trying to call Jacob.
Okay, so how do I get there if I go down Winners? So apparently there's a huge wreck that I have to go to right now because Jacob's not answering his phone and Andy's not here.
Okay, where do you stand on your story?
I just started pulling out my clips. I have the story in mind already.
You're okay.
I should be okay.
Okay, well, where is the
wreck? Accident. So my goal is to get back before 9. The only thing is, I don't know how big this wreck is. But since I have a package that I barely started,
to get in and out, get info and leave. Ah, oh, there it is. I don't have a green vest. Ah, what do I do? Where do I go? I'm with K-Tab. Is there any way I could just park right here?
Well, you stay out of traffic.
Will do, thank you. I did. Motorcyclist, right? No, he told us. Yeah. I used that and I could see the body.
I said it appears somewhere.
I see with my own eyes there's a body. And then mentally, without a doubt, because you're having to think already what you have to write, you're in such a deadline. We already have so many things aside from being an MMJ that you have to do, social media, web stuff. You're thinking about that all the time. And then having to come up with story ideas every single day. Yeah, it's draining. So I need my good cup of tea and candles at the end of the night. Okay, bye guys.
Bye, Matthew.
See ya.
Leaving?
Yeah. I still have a package to do for 10. It's not the first or the last having to do an hour package, but I wanted this to be a good one. It's okay. It's a simple package anyways. It's about love. It's about, I just want to get the quirky stuff, you know? I don't want to miss all that. Okay, I gotta focus. Focus! So is there any way I can create a bin and you guys create a VO? A cut of VO?
Cheers.
How are you doing?
I make that happen.
Okay, I'll create a bin under my project. The tough thing is kind of switching your mind from a future to a deadly accident. And then going back.
The romantic duo say they've never done it. The romantic duo say they've done everything they can together.
Hey, what's up?
Hey, you said you were sending your package up? I'm sorry.
No, I was just tweaking my audio, so I'm not too far from done. Is it already forecast?
We're in break, so you have like 3 minutes.
Okay, that's perfectly fine. I will tell you the order of the CGs.
With coverage you can count on, this is KTAB News at 10.
It takes the right ingredients to make the right.
As KTAB Nightbeat reporter Matthew Torres finds out, a recipe to a great success requires the right ingredients.
It takes the right ingredients to make the right pizza. And to create a heart-shaped one, well, that requires a little love.
Aww. You need a release of energy. I guess in a smaller market, we're all young and somewhat immature still, so we're still vivacious and not as put together yet. So as soon as I stepped out of that door, I yelled. I was like, ah!
Very nice.
Oh, thank you.
Very nice. Yeah.
What's the most stories you've covered in one day in your time here?
I've done... I've done two packages of OSA and a VO.
A voiceover is a story where the anchor is narrating the story while the video is playing.
What is a VOSAT?
A VOSAT is a voiceover where the video plays and then it goes into a soundbite.
What is a pack?
A package or a pack is a story that is self-contained. The anchor tosses it to a reporter whose voice is then heard and seen.
Even Merkel's fire chief came to help remove the building off the truck.
I must say it again, small market problems. Something's going on. Do you remember doing that? Like with the VHS?
Mm-hmm.
I feel like I have to do that.
So you have a dead mouse.
At least I was able to say what I just did.
Uh-huh. 3, 2, 1. Christmas came early for the Buffalo Gap Volunteer Fire Department, and today...
The worst part of the job, maybe in a smaller market, is just the lack of, just really having everything to do yourself.
Holly gets a new one thanks to a big donation. And we'll take a look inside this new building tonight at 10.
I'd like to have a photog. I'd like to have a camera person with me so I can focus on writing. But aside from the market size, I want to be in a city where I know I'll enjoy living in. I know there's news that's happening.
My name is Rebecca Turco. I work at WOAY-TV in Oak Hill, West Virginia. At WOAY, I am an anchor slash producer slash reporter for the morning and noon newscast. So I was recently promoted back in February. Before then, I was working as an MMJ, reporting, shooting, and editing my own stories.
Life at 3:45 in the morning, what's it like for you?
It's interesting. Some days it can be really difficult to wake up, and it's kind of jarring when you leave for work and it's dark out, and especially during the summer, you get out of work and it's light, so your sense of days kind of shift.
Are you glad that you're anchoring producing now instead of reporting?
Yes and no. Honestly, for me, I'm glad in the sense that it's kind of a break from the daily grind I was seeing before of reporting.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to Newswatch Morning Edition. I'm Rebecca Turco. Thanks so much for joining us. Topping our news this hour, a baby is found dead in a car seat in Charleston, and the father has been arrested.
What are you doing now that's giving you the break that you weren't getting before?
Well, I can eat. Most other days, I didn't really eat lunch.
As you can see, these steps behind me are cracked and jagged.
I think the most stories I've done in one day was probably 6 or 7, but those were all VOSATs. So you might have to go literally from one story, you're there 20 minutes, then you're on to your next story, and then you're on to the next story, and you can't really dilly-dally because you have to get to everywhere in time and then make sure you get back to the station in time to then write and edit everything and put it online and the whole shebang.
Hi, sweetie. Hey.
Lately, I've been trying to remind myself of the positives, because when the positives come along, they're huge. It's great.
Good girl. Come on.
And those are the days where when you realize that you're actually making a difference, that's when it makes it all okay. That's when it makes the hard work okay, because you know that someone's watching and someone got something out of my story.
As long as I can get it to like stay up there, it doesn't look good in person, but on the air you can't tell, so that's...
I'm Ben Wilcox. I'm the 11 o'clock weeknight anchor for WENY, which is the ABC and CBS affiliate in the Elmira Corning market.
So how long does this process take then, Ben, to upload onto the web?
It'll take up to 15 to 20 minutes with the system we have.
And you have to do this every day with your stories?
Every day.
So how do you like this one-man band thing with it's the Ben Wilcox show?
Well, I'd said last night, and I openly say I don't like it. I am in Corning, New York right now, so I'm about an hour away. You're Alan?
Hi.
I'm Ben.
Hi, nice to meet you. Hi.
Here. I know you're super busy.
What are you doing about food, Ben? Aren't you starving?
Usually, I would be starving. And I'll either bring a microwavable thing to the office or a, you know, I'll cook pasta and put it in Tupperware and bring it in.
I told
Ben to do it.
Joe is not ready. Ben, go.
I'm ready to do the mic check as rumors circulate around a hacking claim, the congressional blah blah.
All right, well, like I said all week, my parents were coming, so I planned a nice indoor activity at the Corning Glass Museum tomorrow and outdoor activity on Saturday.
So you've been paying attention to the forecast, right?
I've always been.
What about the fact that you have to do a little bit of everything here?
Well, I've always liked to write and report. I've always liked to meet people and get to know them and tell their stories. You know, one-man banding is a new concept if you look at the whole industry, or at least it is in larger markets, not in a market this size. You know, I just cannot find the way to enjoy shooting a story. Kind of tell them about the event tomorrow, what they need to know.
Tomorrow's our second annual Strides for Independence Walk to promote disability awareness.
It's not something I particularly like doing, but producing, I've found that I really enjoy that. I didn't really do that at all in college. I could see myself looking for another TV news job in the next year to, you know, move up to a kind of a middle market before Providence. Staying the 2 years to go to Providence, or saying, heck, let's try something else.
All righty, Big Ed, thank you so much.
Where do you want to go?
Los Angeles. That's my goal. Yeah. Go back home.
There you go.
If she were to ever decide to get out of the TV news business, what would your reaction be?
Happy. Because if the day she gets out, it's going to be because it's no longer what fulfills her.
I'm still trying to hold on to my optimism, and I think I'm enough of an optimist, and maybe it's just, to be honest, I think it's just the stubbornness of me that I've put so much time into this career and that this is what I've wanted to do for so long that as much as I want to give up, I know I can't do it just yet. 5 years from now, best case scenario, honestly, I'd want to be working in Providence.
You know, my guess is that Rebecca competed with dozens of other people for the opportunity to do what she's doing, right? So as long as there's this pool of talent who wants to be there, the industry is going to take advantage of it because the industry is getting what it needs.
This first reading has been passed for this ordinance.
Yes, sir.
Now, if I found these kinds of stories coming from people in bigger and bigger markets about they're burning everybody out, they're expecting this surface kind of reporting from everybody, then I think we'd be really facing some huge issues in our business. Where I hear them is in the small market stations where people really are working like dogs, getting paid very little. And again, it's not that new a situation. You have to be willing to push through it, to power through it, and realize that it gets better. And I hope that the really good ones will be willing to do that.
It's cheaper to not have to pay two people, to only have to pay one person.
What are some of your favorite?
AC/DC, Back in Black.
Television news has always been about getting it done as quickly and as efficiently as possible. And the unfortunate thing is that the TV stations tend to mimic one another, so there's not product differentiation in the competition. Television news markets itself based on the personalities.
Okay. Did I tell you about
those personalities tend to be young and good-looking, right? So you have young, good-looking people who want to make it to the big time. And so they're willing to work at lower wages, and they're willing to do this extra work of one-man band style, coverage.
How are you guys celebrating Juneteenth today?
For 2 or 3 years, or until they decide that, oh, I'm not going to make it to the big time, or I'm burnt out.
My name is Colleen Nelson. I'm a general assignments reporter at News Channel 10 KFDA. I'm 22 years old and I'm from Enfield, Connecticut.
That's far away from Amarillo.
It's 35 driving hours. My application process, I just applied to 75 stations all across the country, and I knew that I needed to do that to get a job because it's so hard to get a job in the industry, so I just blanketed everywhere.
This is the file system that Colleen used and created when she was searching for her jobs here. She has them organized according to all the different states that she applied to.
I knew if I went out there and got her set up that I'd feel so much better about leaving her there. And, you know, for me, you know, some people say, well, you did that for your daughter. Well, in large part, it was for me.
The most special gift, I think, or momentum is here, the Connecticut flag and the Texas flag. When Colleen made up her mind that she wanted to go to Texas, that evening when her dad came home from work, he brought her the flags to show her that even though we were in two separate states, we still stood together.
Hi, my name is Colleen. I'm a reporter with News Channel 10. I was going to call over to Red Cross and see if they had any families they could put us in touch with, maybe talk to them about what they're doing for Christmas. I'm looking in archives for Christmas story ideas. We could get in touch with a family who had a house fire recently in the area, and we can just talk to them about what they're doing on Christmas. Oh, that's okay. I just figured I'd give it a shot. We're just looking for stories today. Quickly burning through my list of story ideas right now. Jordan, he doesn't want to go on camera.
Doesn't?
No. Closed for the holiday. Want to go to Starbucks? We can at least go talk to customers.
Yeah, for sure.
So we'll go. It's the one over on Sansi. Off the loop.
Yeah, cool.
We're gonna go, someone went there this morning and dropped off a bunch of money to pay for everyone's drinks throughout the day. I was wondering if you could maybe check on NewsPath or CNN to see if we just have like generic Starbucks video that we can use for B-roll. I mean, I don't know if we're gonna have much because right now all we have are cars at the drive-thru line and stuff. They won't let us go inside. So paying it forward during the holiday season, how important is that, or what does that mean to you?
Well, today's the day that we celebrate the birth of Jesus Christ.
Yesterday, because Monday was so cold during the lag shot, yesterday I had like long johns. Hey guys, how are you?
How are you?
My name's Colleen, I'm with News Channel 10. We're working on a story today just about paying it forward during the holiday season. Great. Anything else you want to say or add?
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. Thank you.
Y'all have a nice day.
Thanks. Thanks, guys. Perfect. Once we have everything shot and good to go, I'll come back to the station. The photog will give me the SD card, and I'll start my editing. I'll import all the video, and I'll check my scripts to see where I'm at in the shows, see what I have to do for the 6, 9, and 10. And then I will write and edit and package and put everything together, drop it into the folder for production to take care of, and then from there, I just go out to the studio and I'll front. I'll front in the 6, which is usually a minute tease, just basically saying, this is what I worked on today. Join us for the news at 10, and I'll have the full story.
Reporting live from the studio, Colleen Nelson, News Channel 10.
So how long did it take to put together the VO?
Oh, probably 20 minutes, I would say, which isn't too bad. And then I'll do a VOB for the 9, which will take me a little bit longer because I'll listen to my sound bites and pick the bites that I want. And then the package for the 10, which takes the longest out of all of them. But packages are, for me, I've gotten pretty quick at them because we have such a short time frame to get them all done, so I can do a package in anywhere from 30 minutes to an hour if I want to take a lot of time.
Don't take selfies.
What do you think about having to do this?
I hate posting. I don't like it at all.
Why?
Because it just takes so long, and by the end of the day, I've written this story so many times, I have to write it for the 5, 6, 9, and package it for the 10. I have to wait until 10:45, until the whole show is over, to be able to clip out my video to put onto the website. And our system isn't really the best, so a lot of times there's problems where, you know, you think you're all set, but it won't show up on the webpage, and you have to go back and try to figure it all out, and it takes a while.
Here we go, guys.
News at 6.
Thank you for joining us. We hope you're having a Merry Christmas today. Homeless residents of...
So what does Walt mean to you?
Oh, Walt is great. He's like our newsroom dad. The infant adult. He just has such a teaching heart, you know. Okay. That he really just helps guide us and point us in the right direction. So he's a great asset in the newsroom, and I'm so glad that we have him. Hi, my name is Colleen. I'm with News Channel 10.
Yes, ma'am. I know who you are.
How are you?
What's going on? I'm all right.
I'm afraid that young journalists won't become old journalists, because of the fact that they have so much pressure and so many deadlines and so many assignments, and they have to juggle so many balls in the air on a day-to-day basis, that burnout is a real possibility.
We were just doing some research about the murder that happened last night, and I was wondering if you knew any details.
No.
Let's get the street sign where it says North Texas Street. Okay, good.
So what do you think of this one-man band thing?
We're so blessed to have our photogs at Channel 10, where, you know, every day you get sent out with someone different. 3, 2, 1. Neighbors say Perez lived here in this house. And it's just nice having somebody there to bounce your ideas off of. And with stand-ups, you can get creative because somebody else is controlling the camera. They can do motion, they can do zooms.
Texas drivers are in for a change when it comes to registering vehicles. News Channel
5 years. I would probably want to be angering, just angering. In 5 years, you know, when I'm a little bit older, I don't think I want to be 27 running around and, you know, doing everything that I'm doing today just because I don't know if I'm going to have that energy. You know, I would just rather, you know, have that control and, you know, just that ability to sit down and anchor.
People just assume that you're on TV and you make a real good salary, but I mean, I have coworkers who work second jobs after they're done with work.
I think it's a crime. I think low salaries in television news is just appalling that nothing has changed. And in some ways, if you do the math and you look at the cost of living index, these young reporters are making less than I made when I started in terms of their purchasing power. When you hear of young journalists in tiny little markets who have multiple jobs because they can't make ends meet, you realize that we're not going to be able to keep the some of the best and the brightest unless they have some kind of financial backing, say their parents are able to support them.
I'm fortunate enough where my parents will support me in little ways from time to time, and they'll kind of sneak money because they know I won't ask, but not everyone is as fortunate. What my mom in particular will do is she'll send me care packages every once in a while. So in the care package, there might be $40 or $60. For Christmas, she was very good, and basically, my Christmas present was basically a check that eventually ended up going toward my rent. So that was very kind, overly kind.
Oh, I love these. Ooh, these are beautiful. And these will be great for work. That's a nice kitten heel, and oh, My mom knows I love shoes.
What does this say about an industry that doesn't pay its people enough? The parents have to pay.
That means you cannot finance the news and information infrastructure that the country needs. It just can't go that way. Can't keep going on that way. It's just going to get, the ranks are going to get thinner and thinner. The beats aren't going to get covered. The issues aren't going to get covered, and we'll be the poorer for it.
And Aaron Watson had to bring his horse to her for her to take it to the Coliseum.
God, that was scary, wasn't it?
When she started with the newspaper, I thought, okay, well, she's going to pull in like $100,000. Because, I mean, this is a position where you're given the public's trust that you're going to tell them not just what they want to hear, but what they need to hear. And that you're not going to censor everything. I didn't realize that they just throw 20 grand at you and be like, okay, see ya, go do your thing. No idea.
One more time, what are you going to get there?
I'm going to get a 6-inch sweet onion chicken teriyaki on Italian urban cheese.
Well, we helped Ben with some of his bills. So, you know, while he was in college, we pretty much paid for the gas that would be used for travel. We still pick that up for him. The auto insurance, typically things around just moving in with his car. So other than that, I think Ben's been able to you know, pay for what he needs to pay for, and it's really not an issue for us to, we're in a position where we can afford to help him out.
When you'll go to these stores, I mean, Goodwill, any good consignment store, they'll dry clean it, they clean it, and it's crisp, and you wouldn't know the difference. So you're better off doing it. It just makes far more sense. And especially when you only make so much money, and it's not as if you get a second budget just for clothing. All right. Let's see if we can get any deals. But it's hit or miss for blouses. Sometimes I can find some nice shells to put underneath. And actually, it's similar to another blouse that I have that I like, so I think I'm 3 for 3.
Yeah.
My guess is the whole thing probably isn't more than 15.
Yeah.
We'll have to see when we tally it up.
$14.81.
Under 15, $14.81.
Isn't it Rebecca, who's about 23 years old, who'd be a millennial, who's working at minimum wage? It sounds to me like she's willing to pay her dues. If you're going to be in the business, you have to be motivated by either a burning desire to be on television, that you're willing to put in long hours, not get good pay, because being on television gives you that juice, right? Or you have to be really committed to your community. And I've met folks who do both. I mean, there are some folks who just make a career of working in a medium market or a small market. They love it. They love their community. They stay. They stick it out. But a lot of times, VJs aren't really expected to stick it out. VJs are expected to work 2-3 years and then just either move up or give up.
Rhode Island was always in my 5-year plan, and I got there in 2, so it's just huge. Oh man, so let's start. Oh man, I'm just so ready to just, you know. And I know it's like someone trying to be in the NBA. I mean, the odds of her coming back here, there has to be. I think her grandmother is looking down on her.
Ah.
Did you start when?
Wednesday, next Wednesday. Uh-huh. So today's Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday. 4 days. So it's coming.
It's coming. One of my favorite bags is my shoes. That's not all of them though. This is so exciting, right? Yeah. It was just a whim and I thought I'll apply and it just all worked out that way, I guess. I don't know. It's a lot. It's nerves, it's excitement, it's my brain right now can't really wrap around it. It's a lot at once. But I think what's gonna help me get through it is just being home. And yeah. It's gonna be good. Well, that word too, home, it's more than, I'm home in multiple ways right now. So it's just good. Don't cry, it's okay.
I'm just glad you're home here.
I'm so proud of you.
Thanks. Can you talk about what makes this case different? Is this different from other missing persons cases? I don't imagine it would be more than like a half hour or so. And then I didn't know what James was thinking when that's done, if I should head back, what he wants. I don't know.
I am a multimedia journalist, so pretty much the same thing I did before, except now it isn't VOSAT patrol like it was before.
Check. Okay. Oh yeah, now it says live. Okay, cool. All right, thanks, bye. Oh, do you need me to dial in now? Okay, cool. Right now we're told they don't suspect any foul play. They are still investigating this as a missing persons case.
Also, for me, the main difference is where I was before, we didn't have any live capabilities aside from being in the studio. So another huge difference for me and another learning curve that I'm still on is getting used to that live mentality, getting used to going live.
B11 and B12 are dead. B11 and B12 are dead.
I'm the 11 o'clock producer at WJAR NBC 10 in Providence, Rhode Island.
All right. So, looks like that story on Rhode Island housing is going to have to go away.
But first, tracking Joaquin, the storm is beginning to move away from the Bahamas.
Stand by.
What I love about Ben is that he was an anchor and he was on the air.
Stand by.
Before he came here as our producer. So he understands what it's like to be on the air. He understands when not to talk in our ear.
I was in Elmira for a little over a year. I'd say about a year and a few weeks. I was the 5:30, 6 and 11 o'clock co-anchor in producing the 11 o'clock news, and the station made a decision to hire an anchor from a top 10 market and wanted to bump me to another show.
And I'm Ben Wilcox. Thanks for choosing WENY HD News at 11. I was out at that home earlier tonight in West Elmira.
And we'd experienced a lot of success on the shows that I was on. We had ratings that more than doubled. So I told them I wasn't interested and found a way out of my contract.
So you took a detour.
Mm-hmm.
So after you left Elmira, what did you do before you ended up at WJAR?
I ended up getting a real estate license. You know, I needed something to do, and I figured, that was something to occupy my time. So I ended up going to real estate class and got my license. Ended up getting two listings within a few weeks of that.
Once we step inside, we have a heated enclosed porch. The porch has a new roof.
I can say that real estate certainly wasn't as exciting as television news, but I was satisfied doing it while I waited for a right opportunity to come along. And if that opportunity didn't come along, I wasn't losing any sleep over it.
So
I was in Abilene for 1 year. I was an MMJ there, and now I'm in Santa Maria, California. I'm at KCOY News, Channel 12, and I'm an MMJ here. Now, give me one sec, I'm just gonna focus.
All right.
Now, how important is the safety, following all the safety rules, and they want to get both sides of the story. They wanna get, you know, the best interview, the best visuals, the best everything, and that's not always hard. That's not always easy to get when you're by yourself. You know, something could be going on and you're here getting your camera ready and something happens and you miss it. So that's what's different. The expectations are higher, but the resources that I have are the same. And you can see the picture on there. You can see that. That's what the control room back in Santa Barbara, that's what they see.
And they say that safety is their number one priority.
It's very important to us that nobody get hurt.
Now, most of the stands that we visited today did pass inspection. The Knights of Columbus here behind me told us that they just want to ensure that everybody has a safe Independence Day. Live here in Santa Maria, Juanita Adame, KCOY 12 Central Coast News.
Yeah, it's a big fundraiser for all of them. They want to make sure they do it properly. Thank you, Juanita.
It's made me think twice about what I want to do as far as reporting, because when you find yourself on the side of a mountain at, you know, 6:37 on New Year's Eve, you know, shooting a live shot about a little bit of snow that fell, you're wondering, you know, is this worth it? I'm back in California, so that's the good thing. And that's kind of where I'm at. I haven't really thought about LA. LA is such a huge jump from where I'm at. This is market 120. LA is 2. So I don't even know how to fathom Los Angeles right now. And do you guys get calls from hikers that are like in distress, dehydrated? Is that common?
Yeah, it's quite common.
3, 2, 3, 2, 1, 3, 2, 1. It's not on. I don't know where I'm gonna go after this. I don't know that I wanna even stay in news, but for today I feel fortunate. My battery on my camera is dying, so I always bring a couple of spares.
What type of person does it take to be an MMJ?
Self-reliant, somebody who's organized, someone who is able to work independently. MMJs are often on their own for hours and hours and hours on end. And they have this product they create at the end of the day that needs to go on the air, online, all the different distribution channels, and then they have to turn around and do it all again the next day.
In San Luis Obispo, Juanita Adame, Fox 11 News. 3, 2, 1. In San Luis Obispo, Juanita Adame, News Channel 3. 3, 2, 1. In San Luis Obispo, Juanita Adame, KCOY 12, Central Coast News.
News Channel 3's Juanita Adame reports.
Jordan Hayner says he sees them quite often.
I don't have a great solution in helping them with burnout. I actually had a reporter just quit and get out of the business recently because she couldn't handle everything that you have to do here. It's a very demanding job, and the bigger the market, the more active it is and the more you're running.
Yes, it's exhausting, and our business has always been exhausting. And it's always run out good people because they just get worn out, and they get worn out very young, which is a tragedy, because you want to keep the best people in the business and not see them washing out because the pressures are too great. And it's unfortunate, but I think it takes some stick-to-itiveness to get past that.
Thank you.
So I was working for KTAB in Abilene for a little over 2 years. Now I'm in Nashville as a morning reporter for News Channel 5, and it's been 7 months so far.
This I got to go do a report for CBS this morning for. So we were talking about just the type of damage we've seen, so we moved different locations. And so by the time she talks to me, this was 6 o'clock, 6 a.m., we moved to a house, and that's where you kind of see the craziness.
Nonetheless, there's still plenty of cleaning up to do. Very messy out here.
Now, we're just moved over to another property here on Hawkins Crawford Road, where as you can see, just plenty of downed tree limbs.
Here, you know, I go live 8 times a day, and so you have that time in between every half hour. And so I think in Abilene, I was so used to doing so many things that I was able to do so much under just a certain amount of time. And so here, I only have one job, but I feel like I still can do the social media. I could still do a little bit more research, make some phone calls in between my live hits.
News Channel 5's Matthew Torres has been in the middle of it all morning long at this year's Beach Body Summit. Matthew?
Good morning, Jennifer. Yes, it's the super workout and super, they're really making that a reality. Just take a look behind.
So how do you look at the MMJ thing now? Because now you have a photographer.
I feel bad talking to my friends back in Abilene that still do, that's still MMJ, because I tell them, yeah, no, I don't have to edit. Then they ask me, no, I don't pick up a camera. No, we have a live truck. No, we have an operator who actually, you know, raised the mast. No, I don't write my own web scripts. In fact, I don't have a login to the website.
I'll describe Nashville as colorful and eclectic. Because it's a college town, it's a music town. I think that's what helps, you know, coming from Texas, you have this southern hospitality, and to move to Tennessee, you kind of get the same thing.
I feel fortunate, I feel blessed to go from one extreme to the other, to now really experience this side of news, to now focus on your writing, to focus on your storytelling, to focus on your on-air performance.
So I was in Amarillo for about 2.5 years, a little less than that. And I've been in Altoona for 6 months now, and I am currently working as the morning anchor.
And is coffee your good friend?
Yes. Coffee's always my good friend. It has been for a long time.
Morning.
Day-to-day Amarillo probably wasn't my favorite, but looking back on it, I'm so glad that I did it. I look back on it with fond memories because it's prepared me and it brought me to this point. A lot of times, the police reports and stuff that come in, by the time they send over the criminal documents and stuff like that and we get mug shots, it's 11:30 and it's like scrambling last minute. Listen, we have 4 things in this next block. 3 out of the 4 are not online. Is it easier to move that package down to the bottom of the C block so we can, like, hopefully...
It's
online!
It's online.
Wow. Da, da,
da. WTAJ News in High Definition continues.
This afternoon, President Obama is getting ready for tomorrow night's State of the Union address. It's definitely made me prepared. Now at the age of 24, I'm going to be 25, but to be able to say that I'm a full-time anchor, it's really exciting for me. Now here, my biggest sacrifice would probably be my social life, because it's hard going to bed at 7 o'clock every night when all your friends get off of work at 6, 7 o'clock. Well, you know what else is good? Good news, I guess?
Go ahead.
We're talking about the Powerball, yeah. And no one won the drawing this weekend, which means that jackpot still up for grabs.
Everybody wants to be on TV. Everybody wants to be the entertainment reporter. Everybody wants to be the next big anchor on CNN. Everybody wants to have their own show on Fox News Channel. It's not going to happen unless you come to the first job and realize, I'm an MMJ. I'm going to have to go the city council and find an interesting story in a 3-hour boring city council meeting, and I'm gonna have to make it interesting and make people want to watch it and understand it.
And unless you can do that, Entertainment Tonight's not going to happen.
I'm not a journalist by trade, but I have just tremendous admiration for journalism. And it is exciting when something big is going on. And it's so important, and it's so essential, and you might not live the affluent life doing this, certainly not for a while, but it's really so important. It's really the public interest. It's really the future, not just of your profession, but of your country too.
I tend to just look at things in a positive light, which I think helps, especially in a business and in an industry where there's so much negative. People, you know, telling you you're not good enough, or you don't look right, you don't sound good, viewers calling in mad, things like that. You have to keep things in perspective.
How do you feel about having to start at the bottom and do the work of five people and pay your dues?
I think that's America in general. I mean, if you want to be successful, you do have to pay your dues. And I've seen people pay their dues and are very successful now, and it gives me hope and it gives me inspiration and encouragement.
Perfect.
So I think regardless of the market, you still have to have a big dream.
No one ever says, hey, you're doing a good job. So you just have to find that in yourself and keep that little light, that little spark alive, because no one's going to tell you otherwise.